Hey everybody, my name is Casey Beathard. I would like to share a little story of awakening and forgiveness that I was blessed with in the last little while living in Nashville. But it started way back about 27 years ago when I moved here to try to make it as a, you know, in the country music business. Next thing you know, I was giving my life to Jesus Christ, and that alone is a miracle because I never thought I could be forgiven for the prior life. Oh, as a baby Christian, I'm trying to raise babies in the Lord. And everything we did, we spoke Jesus into them. We surrounded them with love and groomed that way. And my whole world revolved around my children. And a lot of people said I was a good dad. I was coaching them. I was going with them. I was doing everything I could to be to make sure they were happy. I built my world on, depended on what was going on in their lives. Last year, December 21st, that wake-up call in the middle of the night that you need to get down to Vanderbilt Hospital. My third son, Clay, had been home one day from college, and he was meeting his buddies, just good guys, out that night. Next thing I know, I'm walking out of Vanderbilt Hospital. The early hours of the morning. Being told he was gone. Along with his good friend, they had been stabbed. It's ridiculous, didn't make sense. A crushing like it was uncomprehendable. And you walk back into your house trying to figure out what next. And I thank God that our what next became him. Next thing you know, a flood of friends are coming in, and our house just got filled up with truth. That's it. Hope. And Bibles open, and our house became a church. I finally realized in that moment, in those areas of searching, that my son had never been more safe in his life. I'd never had to worry about him again. I knew without a doubt that my son was in heaven and God was who he says he is. I remember my son coming to me with a lot of vengeance issues. And that's when we dug in. And Jesus said, vengeance is mine. So you want to take this on yourself. You want to hold this and be bitter and mad and hold this for the rest of your life. But God says here that he can handle it. And actually, and I realized after that conversation, I was preaching to myself. And the Holy Spirit filled up that room and filled up me at that point. And my heart literally broke for this kid that murdered my son and Paul, Clay's friend. And I realized this kid didn't have an earthly dad, let alone probably know his father in heaven. And my heart broke over that. I never thought I could have that much grace or forgiveness for anybody. Because my life was consumed with my children's future, and it was always somebody's fault. It was politics, it was coaches, it was teachers. And at that moment, I realized this is a fallen world. These are going to happen. We are made stronger in these trials. And the only way through them is with Jesus. And that's where I was. And that's, not only did I have to believe it, I believed it. I was freed. At that moment, I was freed from having to be mad or bitter, wish he would die. I don't wish any of that on him. Because I've seen God could take the most unlikely and make them who they are. And who says that Saul can't become Paul again? Next thing I know, we're in the middle of all these race wars and COVID and all this anxiety and worry, and I thought, golly, Lord, this testimony that you've given me is a blessing. Not only is my son safe, not only is this temporary, but these are promised. We're going to go through them. And if I could get through an injustice that I just had to live through, then I know that anybody can get through anything. But I have to focus. It's a focus of constantly going back to who God is and who Jesus is in your life, and focusing on eternal perspective. This is temporary. It's perishing. And when we finally realize that, that's when we can all hope for heaven and live in that freedom of knowing that this doesn't matter. Let's forgive and love our enemies. Let's pour good on evil like Jesus commands us to. And that's the only way. It's not this side or that side. There's one way. It's Christ. And I thank you all for listening to my story. God bless you.